impaired.
Answer some of your letters when we dip into our mouse mailbag, and we'll have another episode of Teen Angel Returns.
But first, let's find out what's happening in Miss Clump's choir rehearsal.
All right. What? What? The concert is coming up soon. This is the music for our big finale, the Hallelujah Chorus. Yes, yes, I know you're all familiar with it. Let's read it through together. I'll give you your Albert.
Hallelujah.
Okay.
Hallelujah.
Rocky.
Hallelujah.
Dee Dee.
Hallelujah.
And Juniper.
Hallelujah.
All right. The Hallelujah chorus from the top.
Mary had a little lamb.
No, 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 what are you doing? Come on now, please pay attention. What for? The Hallelujah chorus.
ABC.
No, no. What are we doing? I don't know what that means to say. Let's check your pipe. All right, boys.
Hallelujah.
Well, I guess that's right, girl.
Hallelujah.
Let's put it all together.
Can't I wait to sing it?
No, no. Can't you hear? What are you doing? Listen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Row, row, row your boat gently down the
street.
That's really going to the dog.
Tonight, live from Fido, California, it's the Miss Teen Bulldog Pageant. They come from all over the world. They're the loveliest of lovely, both glamorous and graceful, and quite fetching. They all share one dazzling dream. Watch as dozens of these glamorous beauties compete for the chance of a lifetime. Join the fun with host Bud Barker as one lucky lady will become this year's Miss Teen Bulldog.
Oh, lovely. Her face is a gorgeous oasis. She's Miss Bulldog. Miss Bulldog from Hard Hat to Yuppie. She's their favorite puppy. She's Miss Bulldog. We love you.
The Miss Teen Bulldog Pageant, tonight at 9.
Once again, it's time for Mouse Mail, the part of our show where we answer actual letters from our club members at home.
That's right, and our first letter is from Marianne Hagen of Newark, Delaware, and she writes, every time I watch your show, I have a feeling that you can see me somehow. Is that true? Well, Marianne, that's a little far-fetched. You should sit up and don't slouch when you're watching TV. It's best in hell, right? After all, television is a one-way medium. There's no way we could actually see. Don't tickle your brother like that. Come on. No, you don't have to worry about us actually watching you, Marianne. No. Put it down. No, Josh, she's got the remote control. Oh. No, don't change it. Shit.
Oh.
We lost her. Well, it's a nice outfit.
Yeah, it was a great outfit. Yeah. Well, in addition to Mouse Mail, we also get a lot of mail with interesting items for a Yeah Right segment. And we research every one of them to find out if they're really true. For example, Linnea Oliver of Elmhurst, Illinois writes to tell us that, at one point in time, a person can know everything there was to know in the world. And you know what? Linnea is absolutely right.
Mm-hmm.
But it took place a long, long time ago. Take a look.
Good morning, class, and welcome to your first day of school. My name is Miss Grumpusaurus, and I will be your teacher. Well, are you ready to begin your studies?
Yes, Miss Grumpusaurus.
All right. Don't stick your hand in the fire.
Okay. Uh-huh.
Never tickle a dinosaur.
Got that one.
Uh-huh. Avoid falling rocks.
Okay. All right.
Congratulations. You have just graduated. Now come on up and receive your diplomas. Congratulations.
Well, remember, we really do like hearing from you. So if you have a question or a comment for us at the Mouse Club, send it to Mouse Mail, Mickey Mouse Club, Disney MGM Studios, P.O. Box 10200, Lake Buena Vista, Florida, 32830. And if we read your letter on the air, you'll like be a really cool person, and we'll send you one of our Mickey Mouse Club t-shirts.
Hey, Fred.
What?
Look, Mary is back. Marianne, you're just in time for a teen's return. Yes. All right.
Nice outfit. Isn't it nice outfit?
Thanks, Josh. Marianne, that is a great outfit. I don't know, my favorite. It seems like when everything is going so well for Cindy, it seems to all fall apart.
Yeah, I can't believe somebody stole her Mustang.
I don't know, I actually think it was the Donatos.
I'm not sure. Let's find out.
Still no word on the car? Man, I can't sell any raffle tickets until I get it back. And if I don't get it back, I'm going to have to refund all the money. It's going to put me out of business.
You did your best, Buzz.
You failed. I let a hot rod down. And it blew my assignment. Supposed to give this girl some self-confidence. I couldn't even do that.
You're not giving up, are you? That doesn't sound like the Buzz I know. You still have 3 days.
Look, it's impossible. It'll never happen.
Never? The Buzz I know says never say never.
Well, that's true.
The Buzz I know works miracles.
You're right. I suppose you know it better get back to work.
Good golly, Miss Molly, this place is a blast.
It's my life.
Hey, I can hear we're in tune. Say, where's the Mustang? I want to take a look at it.
It was stolen.
Stolen?
Yeah. And if some miracle doesn't happen, there's going to be a donut shop sitting right on top of these pumps by next month.
But what the world does not need is another donut shop.
What am I gonna do? I'm never gonna get my car back. This isn't fair. If anybody can hear me up there, I need your help. Buzz, I want a second chance.
Buzz, you're back!
Like a boomerang on wheels.
Something to do with it. I just know it.
All right, if we get close enough, maybe we can overhear something. Come on.
I want you to come back here.
I don't care what you want, Carrie. I'm tired of you and I'm tired of your whole family.
You walk out that door and we're through.
Is that a promise?
Brian, I was just... Hi.
What are you doing here?
Well, it's a long story.
I've got time. Hey, three's a crowd. I'm going in for a better listen.
Listen good.
I will.
You know, my dad says I get to run that donut shop at the new mini mall, man.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. You guys come by and eat all you want.
What if the Boons find their car? There might not be a mini mall.
Good, good. No problem. Happy to know that that piece of junk is safely tucked away at the 51st Street warehouse. It won't show up until Saturday, and by then, it'll be too late.
All right.
Yeah.
So how do you know your car is in the 51st Street warehouse?
My guardian angel told me.
You're a funny girl, you know? This place gives me the creeps.
Yeah, I know what you mean. Wish my guardian angel was here.
Who knows? Maybe he is.
I don't think so.
Make a mess. Those pieces he left behind won't just rot away. However, on today's invention connection, this inventor created a unique golf tee. Let's take a look.
Hi, my name is Casey Golden, and I invented BioDT. The BioDT is a biodegradable golf tee. One of the problems is golfers sometimes leave their golf tees on the golf course, which makes litter and creates a problem and more blades, as you can see right here. My BioDT breaks down in water, as you can see, and it helps the environment, as the wooden tee does not. The way I made the BioDT is with paste, which is made up of water, flour, and applesauce, which makes it hard, and fertilizer. Then we cooked it in the microwave until it was very hard and sanded it down with a Dremel kit, and that's how I made my BioDT.
The last time my music day guests were here, they were charged with energy. And today, they're just as hot. Here to sing their hit song, Down My Heart. Let's hear it for The Boys!
Thank you.
Introducing ourselves, we wanted to do a rap. Is that possible?
That's great. Right. Hey, man, help us out with the beat.
Huh? I will. Okay. All right. We're working on a little rap. We want to get you guys' opinion. Can you know help us out a little bit?
Yeah.
Hey, Chase, little, come on out, man. For it.
Can I go over here?
We're doing a rap.
Club is videotaped before a live audience at the Disney MGM Studios in Lake Buena Vista, Florida.
Tomorrow, it's the hot tip for tricksters when this club member spends the day practical joking with Night Court Harry Anderson. It's Guest Day on the Mickey Mouse Club.